evening, everybody. Welcome to your glorious Hump Day Wednesday Turning Point for Wednesday, August the 10th, 2022. And episode 314 of the Turning Point series. In this one, we're going to be discussing about the strength you have. Our beginning passage is Judges 6:14 from the NIV, which we'll be comparing to that verse in the recommended reading will be Judges 6:11 through 16. Our turning point is from Charles Swindoll, and our Bible reading is Jeremiah 22, 23, and 24. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Comment, how was your day today? How was your Hump Day Wednesday? How did it go? Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach the 100 subscriber mark by the first day of fall, which is about 4.5 weeks away. And even if I can get 50, I might have just change my mind. If I can get up to 50, I would be happy. If I can get that far up, I'd be happy. But if you do that for me, I will greatly appreciate each and every one that helps me get up there. So without further ado, let's talk about the strength you have. Judges 6:14 in the NIV says, "Go in the strength you have and save Israel out of Midian's hand. Am I not sending you?" So, my version... Let's see. Judges. Here, Judges. Joshua. Judges Ruth. There we go. Judges 6. 11 through 16. And what? 14 is the verse. Okay. "Now the angel of the Lord came and sat under the terebinth tree, which was in Ophrah." O-P-H-R-A-H. "Which belonged to the Joash the Abizurite, while his son Gideon threshed wheat in the winepress in order to hide it from the Midianites. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, 'The Lord is with you, you mighty man of valor.' Gideon said to him, 'O my Lord, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? And where are all his miracles which our father told us about, saying, Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hand of the Midianites.' Then the Lord turned to him and said, 'Go in this might of yours, and you shall save Israel from the hand of the Midianites. Have I not sent you?' So he said to him, 'O my Lord, how can I save Israel? Indeed, my clan is the weakest in Manasseh, and I am the least in my father's house.' And the Lord said to him, 'Surely I will be with you, and you shall defeat the Midianites as one man.'" Great big words. "So Gideon was a young soldier whose nation had been battered in poverty by the Midianites. He was defeated in his spirit as he tried to hide in a wine press while threshing enough grain to keep his family alive. And suddenly the Lord appeared to him, commissioned him to lead his nation against Midian. 'Go in the strength you have,' the Lord told him. And Gideon didn't feel he had very much strength, but he had enough to fulfill God's will. And that's exactly how much strength you have. Weakness comes and goes, depending on illness, age, and the demands of life. But we are stronger than we realize. For the Lord is our strength and our salvation. He will always give you enough strength for what He intends for you to do. And something else, the Lord is our strength, reminds me of a little tiny quirk of a song. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 But you can also turn that around and say, the joy of the Lord is our strength. 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 See? See how easy it is to turn that around? It's just to change the word from my to our. To make it plural. So Erwin Lutzer said, a faithful God does not expect you to do what you cannot. He supplies the needed strength. If you don't have all the strength that you need to do something, God will provide that much needed extra strength to help you get through it. So as we faithfully serve God, He gives us the strength we need for the task He has placed in front of us. So go in the strength you have. And if you need extra strength, God will provide it for you. Amen. So Charles Swindoll says, do you need strength, peace, wisdom, direction, or discipline? Ask for it. God will hear you. Amen. So coming up tomorrow, in your episode 808, part 1, we're going to be talking about all the foundations of the deep. Our beginning passage is Genesis 7:11, which will be another entry into the Genesis Journey playlist as well. But all this is compiled from John D. Morris. Part 2 of episode 808. We're going to be learning about the untold riches from Dave Brennan, derived from Romans 11:33-36. For our Blessed Thankful Thursday, August the 11th. And tomorrow night, we're going to be learning about episode 315. And we're going to learn how to be complete in Him. Colossians 2, 9 and 10 is our beginning passage. And our recommended reading is Colossians 1, verse 19. Our turning point is from J.C. Ryle, R-Y-L-E. And the Bible reading is Jeremiah 25, 26, and 27. How far do we go in Jeremiah? Oh, we go up to Jeremiah next weekend. Not this coming weekend, but the following weekend. We'll end it up on that weekend, the third weekend in. And I know I'm sorry I said the other day that we were going into part 2 of the weekend series. I was actually in the first one, as you can see in the title. It was actually the first one. In my bad, I was like thinking that we already done one, and then I realized that was just the first one. So, but stay tuned for those. I'll get to those in just a few minutes, but you'll see those tomorrow. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy it. Oh shoot, I'm gonna go over 10 minutes on this one. Sorry about that. I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. And He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, Peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back tomorrow for another Blessed Thankful Thursday, and we'll see what God has in store for us tomorrow. So until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you tomorrow. Ha ha. Me and Baby Yoda, out.